Good Old Annie, or as I called it as a child, the Red Album. Anybody? Any Beatles fans offended? All right, obsessed with this, obviously. I mean, who wasn't? That's my age. And the biggest devastation for me, however, was when I got to finally see it on Broadway after dreaming of being in it, you know, and I kind of accepted I'd never be in it because of the whole pre-op aspect, not a girl. But then I noticed the song NYU, noticed there were actually two newsboys, NYU, by the way, NYC. So there were literally two newsboys in NYC, and I was like, oh my God, there are boys in Annie. I could be so excited that I could finally be in Annie. I was like, I could try out, I got my equity card. Turns out they were girl orphans dressed up as boys. Yeah, still devastated about the 11-year-old drag kings. Anywho, speaking of drag queens, we're gonna focus on one of the orphans. Okay, Janine Ruane. Brilliant. Sounds so amazing on the solo, and you're never fully dressed without a smile. And when I went to go see it on Broadway, it became a rap solo. Who cares what they're wearing? And I was like, what the hell is that about? Cut to 1,000 years later, meaning like last year, I was at one of my talk shows in New York. She came to see it. I confronted her. I'm like, you're brilliant on the record. Why did you? Turns out she cracked once at like the Kennedy Center or something, and from then on, like, you have to speak it. Either they told her she had to speak it, or psychologically she's like, I now must speak it. Listen how amazing her voice is. So clear as a bell, and then she literally hits an F. There's no shrillness. It's just the most beautifully, perfectly placed voice ever. Still angry about hearing the rap version of it. Okay, here we go. Oh, so good. Janine Ruane. It's so high for the kids. They had it, hold on. They purposely put in an extra high key, so like, you know, there were no body mics in those days, so the kids really had to project, but it's all on the brink. Let me just say, after the show, they were all strong in applause. Hurry back, hurry back. It's literally vocally damaging. Now listen to how clear she is. F. It's what you wear from ear to ear. Come on! First of all, it's an E vowel and it's an F. Who cares what they're wearing on Main Street or Savile Row? It's what you wear from ear to ear. And then totally upstage by Daniel Bois. So that matters. I get it, you're young. So annoying. After she sounds amazing, the bratty seven. By the way, Daniel Bois. Who, by the way, grew up to have an amazing voice. Remember her in Archie Bunker's play? She's hanging over the top with Carol O'Connor. Sounded phenomenal. Grew up to be a songwriter. She writes for Natasha Bedingfield. Who knew? Okay, I'm still angry about the rap version out of here. Who cares what you're wearing? I do. Okay, now, more importantly, let us discuss Lori Beachman. Lori Beachman is one of the women who changed the face of Broadway belting. I always say it's Melba Moore, Patti LuPone, Betty Buckley, Lori Beachman. They brought Broadway belting up like three steps. Like, no one ever belted that high until they came along. So here, now Lori was just in the chorus of the show. So here she is, one of her chorus solos, and we'd like to thank you, Herbert Hoover. And what I love is she goes, today I'm stealing coal for fire. It's supposed to go, who knew I could steal? She adds a liquid U to new. Who knew, and then the back phrase, who knew I could steal? And of course it's an E, she's amazing on E vowels. Who, and back phrase, who knew I could steal? Okay, here we go, sounds amazing. Oh, come on. You hear that liquid U? I'm obsessed with that. Who knew? She's just anything to expand her solo. She's like, I'm adding an extra syllable to the word new. Who knew you? Okay, here we go. One time.
Today I'm stealing coal for fires. Who knew I could steal?
Amazing placement. Okay, I'm obsessed. By the way, Andrew McCardle told me that Lori would walk around backstage. Her warm-up was like, nya, nya, nya. It worked. Okay, so here she is in NYC. She plays the character of Star to Be. She actually jokes in her cabaret act. Well, you know, she passed away, but in her cabaret act, she's like, did my character even have a name? No, it didn't. Literally, her character name was Star to Be. Like, literally didn't have a first name. Okay, so she comes out in the middle of NYC, and just, I can't even tell you how obsessed I was with the solo as a child. I listened to it over and over and over again. Okay, let's listen to some of it.
Oh, NYC, the hurricane's coming. By bus.
I love the triplets here. love that accompaniment. Dun, 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 dun. And then suddenly, instead of getting the word C to NY, she just cuts them off in a totally new key. NYC, just got here this morning. She has this crazy vowel. So I thought she was saying three books. I'm like, why is she carrying with three? Anyway, it's $3, but it's her crazy vowel. It's $3. Two bags, one me. Yet again, the eval. They obsessed with her amazing evals. She's constant evals. Okay, one more time. So it's going to be triplet, cutting off NYC, coming in early. $3, you decide, and then evals. Here we go.
C-O-N-Y-C, the homework keeps coming. By bus.
By train.
You can explain.
Okay, first of all, sorry, I have to stop it. Literally vibrato with the word just got, she's just like that Broadway style. She so gets it. Oh my God.
Explain there again more.
NYC, just got here this morning. $3, two bags, one me.
Now, they make the bold choice of modulating down. Normally you modulate up, but it modulates down. Three bucks, two bags, one me, and then it modulates down, but it doesn't bring the song down. It actually makes it more intimate. So it's actually a very good choice. Peter Howard was the music director, so I'm going to give him a shout out for that. One more time, here we go.
Just got here this morning. $3, two bags, one me.
And taking it down a little bit. I love that. Instead of up there in lights, she changes it to up there in lights. Ah, it's a great, great change of melody. So good.
Up there in lights, I'll be.
Now this bridge, I was always like, what the hell is she saying? It wasn't until I got the vocal selections as a child. Because her crazy voice goes, go ask the Gershwin, go ask the Gershwins or Kaufman and Hart. So they're composing teams. But she's like, go ask the Gershwins or Kaufman and Hart. You're like, wait, all I hear is style, vibrato, and sassiness, but I don't actually hear what you're saying. Okay, so listen to it.
Go ask the Gershwin lights, I'll be.
Style.
Go ask the Gershwins or Kaufman and Hart, the place they love the best. So California pays big for their art, their fan mail comes addressed.
Okay, it's a little convoluted, but what she's saying is all these big people that write for Hollywood movies live in New York. Though California pays big for their art, their fan mail comes addressed to NYC. The other thing I want you to hear is a really cool orchestration that happens in the background. It's just very interesting, little weird punctuations.
I'll be, go ask the Gershwins or Kaufman and Hart.
You hear that? Bunk, bunk. Okay, that's the first one. For no reason. Bunk, bunk. Yet again, instead of going to NYC, the chorus sings ooh, and she goes to NYC. Yet again, changing the melodies. Here, listen. Okay, now here comes the moment I'm obsessed with. Tomorrow, penthouse, that's way up high. Belt in E flat. People did not belt E flats in the old days. She was like, she literally was like one of the first, I'm trying to think. Because Betty did a D, and he plays the violin. And I guess Patty maybe like 2 years earlier did the E in Metal Ark. But I'm telling you, it was rare for anyone to be belting E-flat. Tonight, the Y, holding it and vibratoing it. It's so exciting. Here we go. Let's just listen to it, because I'm obsessed.
The fan mail comes addressed.
Melody changed.
Tonight.
Crazy diphthong tonight. Listen to the crazy diphthong tonight.
Tonight. The why.
And finally, the ending. I was always like devastated as a child because I'm like, oh my God, her amazing solo is almost over. But it modulates right at the end, and that's what always gave me hope. So I was always like, oh my God, her amazing, amazing solo is ending. I'm devastated. Ah, up a half step. Yay! Okay, so listen. Totally cheers me up.
Why not? That's the way of
she goes,
tonight, the
wine. She's winding down, getting depressed.
Why not? It's NYC.
Yay, I do a music to it. All right, Grandma! Annie, I love it.